And now we move to Professor Li. I address him as Professor Li instead of Vice President, really, because I rather think he's more academic than his actual job as a banker. But whatever it is, he is the particular person touched upon by Joe Mi, that hardworking people, and then he ever made through to our colleagues. If you want to find his house, his residence, it's not very difficult. If you overnight, you see some light still going on in his apartment, then that will be his house. So now I move, I give floor to Professor Li to present his organization and then some of the exchange situations. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I apologize for my voice. Because I traveled 2 weeks before. Today, I focus on the financial social houses in Africa. I just want to tell some banks' practices as an example to see what we do and how we do. First of all, I want to draw a big picture for the relationship between China and Africa. Starting from the New China 1949, we in the first 10 years, we sent the medical teams and agricultural teams to Africa. I think at that time, some African nations just got independent. And New China also needs your votes in the United Nations. Then we are built on iconic project called the Tanzania Zambia Railway. In 1970s. Then we helped Africa to train agricultural and technical engineering. The big controversy and the big causes for China and the big controversy from the world happened in 1990s, 2000 something. That is, we do a lot of natural resources project here. I don't want to speak too much about this issue. I just want to say the objective reason that China was put on the world supply chain at that time, or from that on. Then China turned to some municipal and national level infrastructure investment. In the past 10 years, we really turned to the social and development sector here now. When we talk about the relationship between China and Africa, we couldn't forget the export-import bank of China. This bank is one of the key financial institutions to play an important role on this path. The bank was established in 1994. From that year, I worked for this bank. We are one of two policy banks in China now. Before we have three China Development Bank, my colleagues have the Development Bank here. This bank is under direct leadership of the State Council. And wholly owned by, we have only one shareholder, that is the Chinese government. The bank is the only government concessional channel authorized by the Chinese government. This business line is the key business for our bank or say that this is why we are called the consular. We have more than 20 branches in China. Some rep offices in Johannesburg, Paris, and St. Petersburg. What makes me astonished is that our biggest business is not outside China, but inside China. The biggest borrower of this bank is the China Ministry of Railway. It's different. So, government will sign a master agreement, say Chinese government will give foreign government how much money, something like that, we call it master agreement. Then the foreign government will put a package of projects in the master agreement. After that, these projects, potential projects, will be sent to China Exim Bank. Exim Bank will appraise and make approval of these products. Then we transfer these products to the Ministry of Commerce. So Ministry of Commerce will say yes or no, finally, to these products. After that, the foreign sponsor will meet Chinese contractor. Then they will negotiate the contracting price. So after the contracting price or a contracting agreement signed, China Exim Bank will deliver the loan or money to the borrower. This is the basic mechanism. I want to brief the trade and investment between China and Africa. In the year 2009, China became the biggest trade partner for Africa. The figure then is $198 billion in 2011. 2012. So by the end of 2011, China invested $15 billion in Africa. Take China Exim Bank as an example. The bank financed more than 500 projects in Africa, and most of them are focused on improving people's life and infrastructure. According to Fitch Ratings, China Exim Bank surpassed the World Bank, became the largest loan supplier to Africa. I don't know, I just cite the report. About China Exim Bank's social housing financing business. Housing financing by Exim Bank covers different continents, not only in Africa, but also in other continents. These target countries include Maldives, Mongolia, Zambia, Tanzania, Botswana, Madagascar, Seychelles, Mozambique, Cameroon, Congo Republic, California, United States, Dubai, Algeria, Sudan, Fiji, Benin, Malawi, Equatorial Guinea, Vatican, Kuwait, Libya, Suriname, Jamaica. I just counted from coming these names from our airline. Maybe you the former presentation mentioned the Angola KK project. That is not our bank's business. December 2009, China Machinery Industry Group Corporation and Zambia Ministry of Finance and State Bank signed a business contract. The value is $430 million. then Zambian Minister of Finance issued a loan application letter and a feasibility study for China Exim Bank. Chinese Commerce Division at the embassy recommended the project and recommended that the project would be very meaningful for bilateral political and diplomatic relationship. As a regular practice, 15% of the contract value will be financed by the host country. The 85% for China Exim Bank. The term is 20 years, including 5-year grace period. The borrower is the Zambian Ministry of Finance and State Planning. Repayment equally semi-year. We also did risk analysis. They include country risk, repayment risk, performance risk, like this. The slide shows our ambassador to Zambia visiting the construction site. My conclusion is clear. China Exim Bank supports the social housing sector outside China with both intergovernmental loan and commercial loan. In Africa, it is more at the concession of lending to social and affordable housing. My personal perception is the future task is how to create a business model for affordable housing to attract more commercial funding from China, like Angola KPKs, but more realistic properties. Thank you very much for your attention.